I went to Whole Foods. Why are you putting so much emphasis on the H? Because it's got an H in it, and I like to pronounce it as Whole Foods. Anyhow, I'm going to review these. This is Gorilla Munch Corn Puffs. These ones were $3.49. And these ones were $3.99. And this one is the Choco Chimps. Yeah, I already know how much there was now. New. There's no exclamation mark though, so it's not new. It's just new. Load of gas in there, which is probably nitrous oxide. Pink gas. Because that's how you preserve food. Because if it was air in there, as it's so often said to be, which it isn't, if it was air, it would go stale. When you see food and it says packaged in a protective atmosphere, it's usually nitrous oxide. It's a great gas to compress as well. That's why you get it in things like whipped cream. More emphasis on the H there. They actually smell the same. That's not even a joke. Go to your ironing board and give it a good sniff if you take off the ironing board cover. And it smells exactly the same. That's not good. That's not good. I'll have a ridiculously small sized bowl of cereal. Because I like big bowls of cereal if I ever have cereal. I'm not a big cereal eater anyway. But when I do have it, I like to have considerably bigger bowls. Because I think that's just called for, isn't it? These both save at the vegan, by the way. Oh, I was about to peel it off. It's already open. And I'm using whole milk as well. Yeah, full fat milk. Because it needs to be drank. Because it's only got 2 days left on it. Right. These taste a lot like something I've had before. Actually. Let's have a spoonful of a Master Soul Crunchy. Then I'll leave them to the side and let the milk soak in. Yeah. Ingredients: whole grain cornmeal, raw sugar cane, and raw cane sugar, and sea salt. And it's all organic. May contain traces of peanuts, tree nuts, and soy. Gluten free. Product of the USA! I'm surprised. I'm actually surprised that it's from the USA, because I usually associate USA food as being considerably more laden with artificial ingredients and whatnot. I'm very surprised. There's loads of garb on this about saving the gorillas and saving the chimps and whatnot. Absolutely loads of it. It says it's dairy free. Well, it was. High in fibre! No artificial flavours, colours or preservatives. And even though it's a product of the USA, they've actually correctly spelled the words flavours and colours. That is absolutely fantastic. A good attention to detail. If you've got money to keep buying all this stuff, that was just a cough from breathing in the dust. It wasn't symptoms, okay? It's not the woohoo flu. It was just because it inhaled dust, so. Yeah, if you've got the money and everything and you want to save gorillas and chimps, then I suppose that's why you'd buy this. I tried opening the box without tearing the lid and I've torn it, look. Oh well. Which means it's never going to reseal again. Now these Choco Chimps don't look particularly well coated. Some of them look significantly undercoated. They don't smell particularly chocolatey either. Once again, it just smells a lot like the ironing board. What's in this? Ingredients: whole grain cornmeal, cane sugar, fair trade cocoa powder 5%, molasses, natural flavour, and sea salt. Well, natural flavour can mean absolutely anything. Gluten free, wheat free. Oh, that's wheat free. And products is third party certified, organic by Quality Assurance International. Okay then. Says it's vegan. Says it's organic. Can you buy these in America? Well, can you speak up? Or you can't even in the future. Nature's Path Organic is the brand. And then they've got Enviro Kids written across the front of it. Enviro Kids with a Z, you know, because they think it looks more fun to put a Z in kids. Not too bad. Not too bad. The could have done been a bit more chocolatey. It says that the 5% cocoa powder. I think another 2.5% would have been enough to make these amazing. They're not bad. They're expensive though, aren't they? I mean, £4 for a box of cereal. I mean, I know it's good to save the chimps and save the gorillas, but there's loads of healthy stuff written on the back as well of this. Do you eat broccoli? Full-grown mountain gorillas can eat up to 180 kilograms of green plants a day. I thought I was going to say that gorillas eat broccoli. Have you lost a baby tooth lately? No, you haven't, but fun fact, I lost my last baby tooth at the age of 14. 14, I know! My baby teeth stayed in a very long time, which is a good thing. Check out your fingertip. Just like us, gorillas have fingerprints and nose prints that no other gorilla or human has. Cool, right? Yeah. What's it say about chimps? Probably significantly less. Where do chimps sleep? They rest in the treetops. I told you it'd be less, wouldn't I? Because they're smaller. How do chimps get food? Chimps make their own tools, making things like stems and stones, using things like stems and stones to crack open nuts. Do you play games with your friends? When chimps get bored, they play games too. See, I told you it was significantly less. Let's move back to these, see what these taste like when the milk's setting. I've been inclined to put a bit more sugar on these. They taste a bit meh. They're a bit sticky in the mouth as well. They're sort of got this gooey texture. They sort of stick together into a glue. You know, very weird. Once they've let the milk set in, that is a weird sensation. Yeah. If you want to save a gorilla, find a different way because you might be only buying one box of them. Not chocolatey enough. It feels as if I want to put sugar in these as well. That extra 2.5% of cocoa might make all the difference. Very expensive for what they are. You even get different grammages. 300 gram, 284 gram. Yet these are £3.99. And these are £3.49. Yeah, they're pretty bland. These are all right, but when the milk's set in, the chocolate taste's gone. Yeah. Because the milk seems to have diluted it somehow. And these are just tend to glue in your mouth. That is weird. Anyway, thanks for watching, please subscribe. Tell me in the comment section down below anything you want to know. It says on here, we've donated over 2.5 million so far, exclamation mark. 1% of sales from this box goes to the conservation projects. 1% of the sales. Okay then, so I wonder if I can get these anywhere else apart from Whole Foods. That'd be interesting to know. Anyway, thanks for watching, subscribe, tell me, bye. 1%?!